Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Matthew Hall, and I have a new research study that's just been published that I'd like to let you know about. The topic is on the cognitive development of deaf children, specifically on executive function, which I will abbreviate as EF. So, what does executive function mean? Well, it involves lots of different cognitive skills. For example, the way that we engage in goal-oriented behavior, the way that we regulate our behavior or manage our emotions or our attention, how we think about the future and engage in planning, all of that kind of behavior is under the umbrella of executive function. And it's important for a lot of reasons. For example, executive function tends to predict school readiness even better than IQ does. Now, unfortunately, executive function seems to be something of a weak spot for deaf children. For a long time, research has tended to find over and over again that many deaf children struggle in executive function. And so we would like to prevent that from happening and to fix it. And so in order to do that, first we have to understand what are the underlying causes of those unfortunate behaviors. The research literature has mainly suggested two main proposals. The first proposal is that auditory experience and the sense of hearing is really necessary for the development of executive function. If auditory experience is missing, then executive function will be weak as well. The second main proposal is that language is what's really critical for the development of healthy executive function, whether in speech or sign, that the establishment of a strong first language foundation is necessary for healthy, robust executive function. So these are really two very different interpretations, and for the most part, they have been confounded in the research literature so far, which makes it difficult to determine which one is right. So in our approach, we tested three different participant groups. First was hearing children. The second one was deaf children with hearing parents who grew up with cochlear implants and oral-only education. And then the third group was deaf children from deaf families who grew up with American Sign Language. We assessed executive function in two ways. One was based on parent report, where we asked parents about their children's behavior using a questionnaire that the parents filled out called the BRIEF, the brief, which stands for the Behavior Rating Inventory of Executive Function. And we also assessed the children's skills directly by playing several different brain games with them, each of which assessed a different area of cognitive development. Now, if this auditory hypothesis is correct, that you need to be able to hear to have healthy executive function, hearing children should be fine, deaf children with cochlear implants should be next, and then the deaf native signers should be worse, because the children with cochlear implants have some auditory access, whereas the deaf children from deaf families tend to have very little auditory access and not use hearing technology. Now, if the language hypothesis is right, then both the hearing children and the deaf native signers should be fine, and we would expect the deaf children with cochlear implants to be a little bit weaker, because it's also known from previous literature that children with cochlear implants tend to be at higher risk of language delay. So what did we find? In the parent report part of the study, we found that the deaf native signers and the hearing children were performing equally, but the deaf children with cochlear implants were at higher risk of executive function problems by parent report. Turning to the behavior assessments, all three groups were found to perform equivalently on those assessments. So it's a little bit curious that the parent report and the direct assessments gave us slightly different results with the second group. But one point where both agreed is on the strong performance of this third group of deaf native signers. Even though they were profoundly deaf, their executive function skills were strong and robust and healthy, suggesting very strongly that auditory access is not required for the development of healthy executive function. Our interpretation is that the most important priority is the establishment of a strong first language, but there's a lot more research left to do to make sure that that's the right interpretation. So we are going to continue this work. If you have feedback, please let us know. Thank you very much.